Hey everyone, I'm Pastor Gary Hoban, and welcome to Refinery Life Australia. This year, our goal is to release a new video and a new podcast every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. To begin the new year, we're starting on Sundays with a way to happiness. Everyone wants to be happy, and the New Testament is the greatest authority on happiness that there is. Jesus gives us the key that will unlock the door to happiness. The key is found in the eight Beatitudes. Did you know that the word blessed is sometimes translated into happy? And today, we're going to start with humility, the way to happiness. So the text we're going to be reading from is Matthew 5:3, and it says, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." If you want to read a little bit more, the scriptures that embrace this message are Matthew 5:1-12. But let's pray to start with. Father, on this first weekend of the month of the new year, we thank you for life, health, family, and friends. But most of all, we thank you for Jesus. As we give ourselves, Lord, we commit everything to you. Open our hearts and our minds, and be blessed by the teaching of your Son. In his name we pray. Amen. So name the eight things that would make you happy. If God said to you, today, the first Sunday of 2020, choose eight things that would feel, that would make you happy for the year, and I'll give them to you, what would you choose? Would you choose to be poor in spirit? Would you choose things like mourning, meekness, hunger and thirst, being merciful, being pure of heart, being a peacemaker, or experiencing persecution? Do you think these eight things would make you happy? Jesus seems to think so. Before you decide that Jesus is wrong, consider the opposite of the qualities we've already discussed. Characteristics like pride, pleasure, the seeking of pleasure, aggressiveness, compromising impurity, cruelty and hatred. You couldn't be happy with these things, with these characteristics, could you? Really? Of course you couldn't. So we need to consider the eight Beatitudes is eight steps to happiness. Humility is the way to happiness. In Matthew 5:3, when Jesus spoke of being poor in spirit, he was referring to our recognition of both our spiritual neediness and the means that can supply our need. This poverty of spirit, being poor in spirit, results in the discovery of God's kingdom. People who are poor in spirit do not boast of their attainments or their talents because they know that they have nothing that has not been given to them. Why is humility the way to happiness, do you think? Humility enables you to be honest about yourself. When Jesus spoke of being poor in spirit, he didn't imply that being wealthy was wrong. Money can be handled in two ways, in a Christian manner or in a non-Christian manner. And success and prosperity can lead a person to be self-satisfied and proud, yet poverty can lead a person to dishonesty. Jesus did not teach that the poor are spiritually superior. Not money, but the love of money is the root of evil. The Bible tells us that in 1 Timothy 6:10. And Jesus declared that if you want to be happy, you must be aware of your own spiritual poverty. Nothing is more pathetic than a person who has great need and isn't aware of it. Remember Samson standing in the valley of Sorek. He was surrounded by the Philistines. This is in Judges 16:20, and it says, "And she said, 'The Philistines are upon you, Samson.' And he woke from his sleep. And he said, 'I will go out as at other times and shake myself free.' But he did not know that the Lord had left him. Imagine that, not knowing that the Lord had left you. But poverty in spirit is the beginning of happiness. It is the admission that without Christ, you are nothing. This admission is always followed by the Lord flooding your life with the riches of his mercy and his grace. To be poor in spirit is to be honest about yourself. And this is the way to happiness. Humility compels you to commit your full potential to God. When we realize our own helplessness and place our complete trust in God, we commit our full potential to him. After you do this, you'll become detached from things and attached to God. John 6:9 says, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, but what are they for so many?" This boy came to hear Jesus teach and illustrates this commitment. He took the food he had and gave it to Jesus. Once you are willing to do this, you'll be amazed at what Christ can do with what you have to offer. Andrew asked what we are so often want to ask ourselves, but what are they for so many? In his own hands, the little boy's lunch wasn't enough to satisfy his own hunger, but in Jesus' hands, the small meal became enough to feed over 5,000 people. Never underestimate what God can do with 5 loaves and 2 fish. The moment that you commit all you have to God, the impossible begins. Poverty that produces happiness is poverty of spirit. Total submission to God's will is always best, and humility the way to happiness, because it pushes you to commit your full potential to God's will. Humility prepares you to be filled with the Holy Spirit. No proud soul can be filled with and controlled by the Holy Spirit. A life filled with pride has no room for him. People who are unwilling to be controlled by the Holy Spirit are controlled by selfish ambition. That's why the Lord said that we must become like little children before we're able to enter the kingdom of heaven. Children depend on their parents. We've all been there. And they depend on their parents because their parents are children, then they're not really poor. And as God's children, we're dependent on him. Children don't spend much time worrying about what they're going to eat, or what they will wear, or where they will sleep. They simply assume that their needs are going to be met by their parents. God, our Heavenly Father, is responsible for our care. We are told to cast our cares on him because he cares for us. Jesus said to the disciples in Luke 11:11-13, "What father among you, if his son asks for a fish, will instead of a fish give him a serpent? Or if he asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" The poor in spirit know they are poor in spirit. They know they can do and be nothing without the indwelling of the Spirit of God. People who find happiness through humility allow the Holy Spirit to fill them. Humility that enables you to be honest with yourself and commit everything to God is the way to happiness. As we finish up here today, do you want the kingdom of heaven? Do you want it now? If you do, then dig deeply and build your life on the foundation of humility, because it is the way to happiness. Until next time, stay in the blessings.